Google Sheets can have many tabs, and the name for each tab can be up to 50 characters. And this gives you a sense of just how many characters that looks like. By using this All Sheets, you can see all the tabs, but it only shows you 8 at a time, and there's no additional comments that you can make. So I'm interested in creating a table of contents, which would list all the tabs and links to all these tabs. So I found this YouTube video by Bootstrap Tools that programmatically generates a Google Sheets table of contents. Now, I'm not experienced with AppScript or macros, but their instructions are relatively easy to follow. But rather than explain the code, their video does that. I just want to show you how it works. And this is done through the Extensions tab for Google Sheets. So I'm going to build out an app script, which opens as a new tab. And then going back out to this video, actually the comments. So I'm just going to copy this off, Control C to copy it, just paste it here. Now there are two required edits. The first is this one, which looking back at my sheet, I'm going to call Table of Contents. So I'm going to change this to Table of Contents. And the other one is this. You have to insert your spreadsheet link here. This is grabbing everything but the zero following the equal signs. I'm going to paste it here, and you can see there's no zero, which is the first page. Then I'm going to save it, and we've got it as generate TOC because that was the name that was given. And what I can do is just test run it. So I'm going to click run. So I'm going to say OK. I'm going to review my permissions. So I'm going to choose an account. I'm going to allow, and then it ran. Looking back at my sheet, I'm going to expand this sheet just because I know that I have some big ones down here. And so what this allows me to do is to link to the tabs. The video goes a step further and shows you how to actually make this into a hyperlink. But this gives you the basic idea. Now that we know it's working, what I can do is to add as a macro. So I'm going to go out to macros and I'm going to say I want to import a macro. And I'm going to add a function, which is this one. I'm going to close it. And now if I go out here and I say macros, I now have this one. So let's just add one more sheet here. So I'm going to add it after tab 3. And let's add one here and call it sheet 23. So now if I just go out to my extensions, to my macros, and I generate TOC, it's running it, it's finished it, and I go back out to my first tab, Table of Contents, and what I can see is that I now have a sheet 23 as well with a link there. Now what I also did was to build out in this, if I look at any of them, what I've done is I've put out there just a link using the share feature. So if you do file share and share with others, what you're able to do is to grab the link and you can paste that in. What it's going to do is it's going to open as a new sheet on sheet tab 1, and then you just close the other one, and what you've got is a way to be able to navigate back to sheet 1 pretty simply. This also allows you to add notes. So if you wanted to say for sheet 2, this is info about sheet 2. And so you could add additional notes and columns, whatever else you needed out here. Obviously, when you run the macro, you're going to run into trouble. So if what I want to do is to add a new sheet here, I've added in a 25, and looking at my table, what I've got is the information about sheet 2. If what I do is to run my macro, it does, it says this is about sheet 2. So what I can always do, just as an easy kind of fix, I want to move this down, insert one row above. So what I then do is just highlight these cells, just this and the link, and I'm going to delete these cells and shift it up. But again, take a look at the video and you can see how all this works, but this is a neat little use case. Thanks for watching.